So let me ask you about the other incident in the police, because it's amazing to me that the police are still doing this when they're on camera, when there's a crowd filming them, because we've been in this "we caught bad cops on tape" era now for almost a decade. You'd think that even if the cops wanted to do this at this moment, after seeing many other police now being sent to prison for this kind of stuff, you'd think they'd go, "Oh shit, there's a crowd with a camera. I really should take my, I don't want to take my knee off his neck, but I'm going to, because for me, what is it with the cops that they're still doing this? Is it the training? Why didn't the other three cops who were there, why couldn't they have found it in themselves to say, come on, buddy, you know, in a bar fight, you stop your friend. Come on, that's enough. What is it with the cops that they're still doing it?
Part of it is people don't go off to jail, right? No one, very rarely are
some
police officers convicted of murder. So I think that, you know, there's a sense of entitlement around that. And I think there's a certain amount of sort of expectation of who's going to be on your side. Did you know police shootings of civilians go up every year? They've been on the rise. Even as violent crime has gone down, police shootings of civilians goes up. So yeah, I don't think that anybody feels, listen, there's going to be some kind of retribution and I'm going to be held accountable, because the opposite is actually true. Sure, some people get fired. They can go and get other jobs. You know, they very rarely actually are penalized to the full extent of the law. And we know what really happens frequently. If it does go to court, then, you know, sometimes people are free. And then it kicks off days of rioting, obviously. So, yeah, I think that it's very rare that there's some big penalty and everybody's afraid of being penalized.
Well, there used to be no penalty. And now in the last 5 years, we have seen five or six policemen go to jail for quite a long time. So I don't know if that argument really still holds. Is it not more about the attitude? I feel like with the police, and I know most police are good, even though we have a lot of bad videos, but I've certainly known cops, personally known them, and they are not bad people. They're very good people, and it is a very difficult job. But it just seems like maybe we attract the wrong type sometimes. You know, the one who is going to make up for high school. They seem to be obsessed with, you know, this guy seems to have done this, I think, just because the crowd is saying, stop doing it. So he's like, well, then I'm not going to. I'm in charge. It's always about recognizing my authority. The essence to me of the police problem is bad attitude.
I was shooting a doc in New York City, in East New York, actually. And as I'm shooting that doc with a guy who'd been stopped by the police and roughed up and had a case against them, literally the police would do sort of UEs in the street to kind of show off their power. And I'm like, I'm literally shooting with two cameras a documentary on this very thing. So I do think there is a certain amount of power, of, listen, we're the authorities here. You see it a lot. And yes, I think it's a very stressful job, obviously. But also, those few people who go off and get incarcerated, they are, compared to the number of civilian shootings, that's a small percentage. That's not a large number.